All right, what's up, Squire? Back again with it on the channel, and today we are back with a Dragon Ball Legends video. And today it is about time of the month yet again to do a Ultra slash LF tier list. Of course, not a top 10 list specifically. I will get to that eventually, perhaps maybe sometime next month or something. But at the very least, we are back yet again for another LF Ultra tier list and all stuff. Only summonable Ultras, by the way, not free to play Ultras. So there's that. Obviously, with the release of the tags for Zan 4s. They're the main new addition to the list, really. That and then the Zen Kaiola Super Saiyan 4 Goku is right beside them, which you can't see, but here he is. So there's that. I don't know. We have a total of 40 units to go through, so I'm going to try my best to get through these units as quick as possible and not make the video too lengthy. So we'll see what we can do with that. So if I maybe skip over some units and don't explain too much about them, that's why. I'm just trying to get through all these units as quick as possible, so that way the video isn't way too dragged on and all. So do keep that in mind. So there's that. So here is last month's tier list. As per usual, I always like to pull up last month's tier list just to kind of like compare the list, so that way we have a look at it at the start and then we look at it at the end just to see exactly how different things are. So here's last month's Beast Gohan, best tier in the game. You have Z tier looking like this, S plus tier, S tier, all this stuff. B tier, you can't really see. The only thing you're really missing is Evolution Blue. Vegeta's right behind my face cam, but it is what it is. Regardless, let's start off with B tier, actually, just to get rid of, you know, these types of units. And also Evolution Blue Vegeta's B tier because he's not really that great right now. LF Rose is B tier. Who else is in B tier? I want to say Beerus, 100%. UI Sign Goku, yeah. And then who else is in B tier? LF Super Saiyan 3 and Goten. I haven't used Goten in a while, I'm going to be honest. I'll put Goten here, might as well. Do I put him above Rose or do I not? We'll do this. We'll do this. And then LF Super Saiyan. I will say I did use LF Super Saiyan 3 Goku lately. He actually didn't do too bad. You know what? I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt just because of the fact that I actually used them lately. He actually did solid in that video. He actually didn't do too bad. So, you know what? I'll put him in A tier, but it'll probably end up being the lower end of A tier. But I'm going to put him there. I don't know. Just judging off of my personal use, because keep in mind, this tier list is my own opinion. You don't have to agree with any of my takes and all that. You all can feel free to disagree with anything on this list. That's completely fine with me. But I don't know. Just based off of my own personal use of this character as of late, I feel like he's actually not too bad. Again, I haven't used, like, the UI Sign I use lately. He's okay. He's okay. Rose, Dog, honestly, I'm sorry. Yeah, whatever. We'll keep him there. Rose is not that great. Evolution Blue Vegeta I've not used recently. Maybe I might get to use him soon, but I don't know. And then Beerus, I just haven't used him, but he's just aged. I don't know. Simple as that. Okay. Anyway, let's move on to some other characters, I guess. You know what? Let's rank Gogeta Blue. Screw it. Gogeta Blue, I think I'll put A tier. I think at this point, where did I put him at last time? Yeah, A tier. So I feel like A tier is a fine spot for him. As of right now, until he gets a Plot Equip or a Zenkai, he's definitely not in the greatest spot ever. Who knows? Definitely once he gets a Plot Equip or a Zenkai. Honestly, I feel like right now it's more likely for him. I want to say maybe a Platinum Equipment. We could get another LF Zenkai throughout the celebration. It's definitely not impossible, but with the fact that we just got LF Super Saiyan 4 Goku Zenkai literally like 2 weeks ago or something, very recent, I don't know if we're gonna get another LF Zenkai that soon. I don't know. We'll see. I could be wrong, but either a really good Plot Equip for him or Zenkai should be enough for him. But as of right now, he's A tier. He's just okay as of right now. Not the craziest. You know, let's rank Vegito Blue. Vegito Blue, I'm gonna put S tier. I think he's still good for sure. I did use him lately. Granted, it was double supported with Pan and Future Gohan just for the sake of the video, just to try and test him out on that team. With support and on the right team setup, if you build a team around him, he definitely can perform quite well still. But if you're not, again, if you're not babying him, if you're not building the whole team around him, supporting him and all stuff, he's okay. Like, he can still do fine for you, but not the craziest of all time. I don't know. He's okay. He's S tier. Honestly, I think this guy's S tier as well. Probably, I don't know. This guy's still good, but you know, yeah, I'm gonna put him S tier. I'm gonna put him S tier. That's not around that S plus tier just because the meta's changed so much, and this guy can still keep up pretty well, but I feel like he has fallen down a little bit, just a bit, but he's still good. So, you know, I'll put him in the top of S tier. Sure, might as well. FSK, honestly, you can be, do I want to put him below or above? Where did I have him beforehand? I had him below Gogeta Blue. You know, yeah, sure, might as well. I don't know. I haven't used Red Gohan in a while, so I can't really rank him that well as of right now. So keep that in mind. I don't know. Whatever. Sure, I guess. I don't know. Who else are we gonna rank? Cell. Let's rank Cell. I think Cell. He has a case for being potentially Z tier, but I think I'm gonna put him S plus tier. I think S plus tier is a fine spot for him. He definitely can have use in this meta for sure, with Beast Gohan still running around and all that. Hybrids just in general being very dominant. Future Gohan, then you also have Pan and all that. So obviously doing additional damage with Hybrid Saiyans can definitely help. Also the fact that now Tag Super Saiyan 4s now exist. They're a green unit, at least when Goku's in the field, so he could potentially counter them at that point. So he can have some use, but at the same time, his teams are not really in the crazy spot. Powerful opponent is okay. Regen is not in the best spot. Future's okay. I don't know. I think because I'm going to put him S plus tier, but I don't know. I think this is a fine placement for him. Who else? You know what? Bardock. Bardock's kind of like a hard character for me to rank. I think he's S tier. I think he's S tier because he's actually not too bad. I've seen Bardock a little bit lately. I haven't used him myself though much, but he's definitely not a bad character. He's definitely one of those characters that if you have higher start, and now I feel like more people are going to have access to him, and especially depending on what team setups you run him on, he could actually be solid for you, but I'll put him S tier. What did I have him at before? I had him S tier behind Vegito Blue as well. Do I think he's worst of Vegito? I'll put him there. I think that's a fine spot S tier for now. We'll see how things play out later on the tier list and all that. Jiren is a character I just don't use. Like, Jiren is just a character I just really don't use. Is he better than Vegito Blue? Maybe. I think where did I have him at before? I don't want to base the tier. I kind of want to stop looking at this list just because I don't want to base it off too much of last month, because it's not last month. It's this month. It's just, Jiren is not a character I use. So, like, but just based off of past experience. Full Power Frieza, I think, still S tier. I feel like he actually can have decent use in this meta just because of his endurance nullification. That's probably the main thing, to be honest, versus Beast Gohan and even like Future Gohan and all that. So he can have use there, but outside of that, his tanking is not really great. Damage at this point has definitely aged quite a bit, and just LOE right now is not a bad team, but they're definitely not the best team. I'll say LOE right now, they can definitely put in work offensively, but they're a very glass cannon team for sure. So just overall, LOE is okay right now. So I'll leave him in S tier though, but it'll probably end up being like in the lower end of S tier. Cooler, I still think Cooler Z tier. Cooler's up is still very good. He did fall off boost, which I kind of didn't even realize he would fall off boost until now. I thought you'd have at least one more season in there, but he did fall off already. LOE again is not in the craziest spot. Movies, you don't really see this guy because guess what? Pan is just the better option for movies. Super Saiyans are not really running around that much, so that kind of hurts him. He definitely still has the situations, obviously, that he can definitely still put him working. You don't want to underestimate him just because he's not in the best spot in the meta right now, but at the same time, you know, I don't know, there's just better units right now. The meta is not exactly the best for him, but his stuff is still a good unit. I still think worthy of being Z tier, so I'm gonna put him in Z tier as well. Future Gohan, I think, is also Z tier worthy. Is he better or worse than Cool? The thing is, Future Gohan's a very interesting character, because I know a lot of people, I see a lot of people rank him either at highest, even like top three, maybe even top five worthy or something, but at the same time, like, Future Gohan, yes, I see his value. He's definitely very good, easily a, like, top tier character and all that, especially just for his value on the Hybrid Saiyan team, especially running alongside Beast Gohan and all that. But at the same time, him individually, there's a lot of characters that are better than him individually for sure, and I feel like we kind of have to understand that to an extent. Like, for instance, I don't know, let me pick out a random character that I know individually is better than him. Ultra Gogeta, I think, is better individually than Future Gohan. So again, I get Future Gohan's value and his support for the team, but at the same time, I feel like just basing him off of value alone and that's it, I feel like that's not really, like, you have to like take everything into account, not only his value for the team, but also how good is he actually individually in terms of, like, his offense, defense, you know, all this stuff. You have to take everything into account. Yes, you know, if you take everything into account, including his support and how well he works with Beast Gohan and Pan, yes. Because of that, you know what? I will put him above Cooler, but I will keep Ultra Gogeta above him. I do think Ultra Gogeta, even though you definitely don't see him as much in the meta. That's another thing too with certain characters. Like, I remember Majin Vegeta was a character that back during the Cooler meta, people were like potentially putting him Z tier worthy. Even I put him Z tier worthy and all that potentially. And all that, just because of his values are in the cooler meta. People were kind of downplaying him just because you didn't see him that much. And yes, you didn't really see him that much, but that doesn't mean that he's bad. Just because you don't really see a character that much, that doesn't mean they're just outright trash. Like, it's just people are not using them that much. But Majin Vegeta during the cooler meta was very good. In fact, Majin Vegeta even now is still quite good. I'll still probably put him S plus tier, maybe. Is he better or worse than Cell, though? You know what? You know what? And also keep in mind, Majin Vegeta, I'm going to have a little bit more bias towards, too, because he's my favorite unit in the game. Majin Vegeta, again, I did also use recently. He can still put in work. Just because, you know, he's not in the cooler meta and he can't just as easily shut down the best red in the game being Pan and all that. Majin Vegeta can definitely still put in work. He can still have value for you, still put on a lot of damage for sure. Tanking is okay. His teams definitely hold him back a decent bit, but then again, Cell's teams are also not the greatest. I don't know. We'll leave Majin Vegeta there for now. I can obviously change things as I go on with the tier list, but yeah, I don't know. Just keep that in mind. So Gogeta, I do think, is better than future Gohan. I think he's E tier worthy as well. Ultra Super Vegeta, might as well just rank him. I think I'll put him here. I'll put Super Vegeta there. I do think Gogeta is better as right now. Vegeta is definitely very, very good for sure, but I do... Every time I've used Gogeta as of late, I feel like he's just way more valuable to me and just way more useful, and he's able to just dominate a lot easier in this meta, especially because of the fact that his endurance nullification on his ultimate. And that endurance, that 30 timer count endurance nullification on his ultimate is crazy valuable, especially versus Beast Gohan. The amount of matches I've won because of Ultra Gogeta is crazy. So there's that. So I'm gonna put Ultra Gogeta above Super Vegito there, but Super Vegito is definitely still Z tier worthy for sure. Broly, you know, let's rank Broly. I do think Broly, I'll put above Gogeta. I do think Broly is potentially the best ultra in the game right now. I haven't used Broly that much, but just based off when I fight him and just based off of like general knowledge and just from my past experiences with him, he's definitely good. He's probably one of the few units in the game that can actually tank. Granted, he is on boost and he's definitely a star dependent character for sure. I will say that, but I don't know. Broly's definitely a good character for sure. Definitely his damage isn't really the craziest, but he does come through with utility, you know, the defensive aspect of him and all that. So I don't know. Broly's just a very good character overall, I feel like. So I'll put him there, especially also you can run him very easily with Pan and, you know, Beast Gohan, and he works decently well with him for sure. So I'll give him that, sure. We'll talk about Tag Super Saiyan 4 in a little bit. Let's just rank like a couple more units. I don't know, like, what's a random unit I can rank? You know what, let's talk about him now. Actually, no, let's talk about LS Super Saiyan 4 Goku first. LS Super Saiyan 4 Goku, I do think, is very, very good right now. Obviously, did Zenkai about 2 weeks ago. Obviously, the last time I ranked him, he didn't have his Zenkai, so do keep that in mind. But definitely very good. I do easily think he is Z tier. I think I'm gonna put him future, dude. I keep looking at future Gohan. I keep, like, a part of me wants to move him up a bit higher. I kind of want to put Goku there. I do kind of want to put Goku there just for the fact that obviously GT is quite good right now. Obviously, even on Sun Fam, this guy has a lot of value. He does work pretty well with future Gohan and Pan. Although I will, future Gohan, what, Beast Gohan and Pan. Although I will say future Gohan is probably a bit of a better pick though than Super Saiyan 4 Goku. You know what? I will move him up, but I'll put him there. You know what, actually? I think I like this. I actually do like this. Broly's definitely quite good. But I do think these guys are a bit better off in the meta right now. To me. Again, I haven't used Broly that much lately. He's also not a character. I fight against Broly, but every now and then. He's not really the most common character of all time. But I think I like this. I'll move future Gohan up just because he is good. I know I went on like a bit of a ramble on earlier, but he's good. I don't know. Okay, this is a D tier for now. The Super Saiyan 4 Goku's definitely good offense, supporting your team, Defense is alright. He does have utility, of course, with the cover rescue. It's going to come in clutch, especially for him on GT. You can use the cover rescue up to 2 times, which is definitely very, very valuable for sure. Now that he has card draw speed, and he can get special cover change nullification with the defeated ally as well. His ultimate hits freaking ridiculous. This guy, last man standing, or with the defeated ally, you definitely do not underestimate this guy whatsoever. This Super Saiyan 4 Goku is a very, very capable option for sure. You definitely don't want to sleep him whatsoever. So I think this is a good placement for him. I think I like it. I like it. Okay, Tag Super Saiyan 4. Let's talk about Tag Super Saiyan 4s. Tag Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Vegeta are definitely very, very, very good right now. Obviously, yes, they can be a bit of a glass cannon for sure, but their damage output is very, very good. Obviously, you know, with the tag mechanic, it gives them, you know, advantage over blues as well as also purples as well. Having special cover change nullification is definitely helpful. Their AoE green cards are very, very powerful. Their blue cards potentially restoring vanish and doing good damage is definitely good. Vegeta with the insane levels of card draw speed is crazy, obviously, and then Goku's raw damage output definitely is quite good as well. So overall, this character is very, very good. I do think that they do fall short compared to a certain other character, which I feel like should be obvious, but I do still think they are very, very good. So therefore, I am going... I don't know if I should put them in this tier, or should I actually put them in this tier? Alongside this guy. Because this guy, I do think Beast Gohan's better. Like, Beast Gohan is just freaking ridiculous. We don't need to get into exactly why Beast Gohan is just broken beyond belief. I feel like it should be kind of obvious. Like, I think Tag 4s are on their level? You know what? I'll do this. I think I like this a bit more. I do think Beast Gohan is a step above everything else right now. They're very close. They're probably the closest thing to Beast Gohan as of right now. But that is it. I don't know. They're very, very good for sure. Just because they fall short of Beast Gohan, that doesn't mean they're bad whatsoever. Again, the only issue I have with them is defense. Definitely, they kind of do feel like a unit that after boost, they might fall off a decent bit. But I still think they're going to be quite good for sure. So, I don't know. They're definitely a very good unit for sure, but Beast Gohan is just superior. That's all I gotta say. So, there's that. I don't know. What's another character we can move on to? You know what? Let's talk about Ape Vegeta. Ape Vegeta. I haven't used Ape Vegeta, though, in a decent bit. We'll do that. Again, I'm not going to mention much about Ape Vegeta. I've not really used him that much. This is just going off of just past knowledge. That's it. Simple as that. Dragon Fist. You know, I don't want to disrespect my boy Dragon Fist that much. I do obviously get Dragon Fist has definitely fallen off, and he's not in the craziest of spots right now. But he can still have value. When I have used him lately, which I have used him a decent bit as of late within the last couple of weeks and all that, you can definitely still put in work, especially if you're able to get his gauge filled. His ultimate can pretty much almost one-shot a lot of units still, even to this day, or at the very least do a hell of a lot of damage. So, I don't know. His nuking capabilities are definitely still quite good, but I don't know. MUI as well, I will put MUI above him still. But I don't know. MUI is also not in the craziest spot right now just because Beast Gohan. But although I will say he has returned finally in a banner, so maybe at higher stars he could do that. I don't know if that really helped him, to be honest. I don't know. MUI is definitely still a good character for sure, though. He can still work in this meta, but he's definitely just not in the safest spot ever. G4. I think there's an argument to move up G4 a little bit just because of the fact that GT's gotten buffed lately. Although he has been replaced by this character, obviously, which they are miles better than this guy. I think there's a bit of an argument to move him up to S tier, I feel like. I think that's solid. I know, yes, his team has gotten buffed, but there's a better unit now. He's gotten replaced, but still, maybe perhaps for players that haven't pulled him and has like a sub option potentially, and maybe even running him alongside G4 or running alongside Tag Super Saiyan 4s. He could do okay. Definitely, you do need to Zenkai buff him if you're going to use him. He's definitely very Zenkai buff dependent for sure. And all that. But I don't know. He could have some use, but I do think he falls short to a lot of other characters. I don't know. That's the only reason I'm moving him up, is just GT has gotten buffed. Yeah, I don't know. I'll just put him there. Sure, whatever. I can change him later if I want to. A Piccolo. Like A tier, honestly. I feel like it. Is he better than Gogeta Blue or is he worse? Yeah, I'll put him above Gogeta, sure, whatever. Piccolo's not too bad. I did use them not too long ago, but it also has been a little bit since I used them. I don't know. The last time I used them was, I think, during the cooler meta. It was right before Beast Gohan came out, so I haven't used them during this current meta that we're in. I don't know. We'll see about Piccolo, but I do think he can still be okay. I don't know. I don't know. Gogeta Blue has, like, higher potential. I feel like that... Whatever. It doesn't really matter that much. Whatever. Fine. Sword of Hope. I think he can still be solid for sure. I think this is like a fine placement. He's been power equipped for sure. And at this point, he definitely needs a plot equip. But he can still have some use. Defensive wise, he can actually be okay. Once he gets his gauge, his damage can still be solid. His ultimate can definitely hit like a truck. He's almost like a similar situation with Dragon Fist. That if you get his gauge built up and you're able to actually catch your opponent off guard with an ultimate, that ultimate can really hit hard, maybe even harder than you expect it to sometimes. But I don't know, just overall Sword of Hope has aged, but I do still think there's a he still deserves to be somewhat high up, so I'll put him there. It's fine. You know what, Goku and Vegeta, where did I have Goku and Vegeta last time? Goku and Vegeta, I did use Goku and Vegeta lately in my last video with the triple tag team. I think like here, honestly. Yeah, I'll put them there. That's fine, honestly. They've just aged at this point. They're okay at this point. Kid Buu. Where did I have Kid Buu last time? Above Blues. Yeah. And it's just Kid Buu right now. It's like, he's okay. Like, he has the situations where, like, he can pop off. And it's just, with this insane Vanish Restoration, he can definitely have use and he can be good. I don't know. Kid Buu is just, his ultimate hits really weak. And if he gets touched, he... then again also regen and powerful opponent are not that great, but then again Goku and Vegeta, like, you don't, they've been replaced on their teams many times. I'll give Goku and Vegeta the benefit of the doubt as of right now, but that's it. I don't know, it doesn't really matter that much, but yeah, sure, whatever. Revival Gohan, I do think, see, Revival Gohan is a unit that, like, he's definitely very good for sure. I do think like there is fine. I think that's like a fine placement for him. I do think he's still like Z tier worthy just because of his value, and he's definitely aged pretty well for sure. Obviously on hybrids definitely gives him a lot of extra value. The revival options definitely still good. The support he provides, once he revives, he still puts in a lot of work as Super Saiyan 2 Gohan. So I'll put him Z tier, but he's definitely low end of Z tier 100% for sure. So I'll give him that. Tag droids, I do think they're S plus tier. You know what, I'll put him above Majin Vegeta. I'll put him above Majin Vegeta, but at this point, they've definitely been power crept a decent bit as well. They're definitely not too bad. They can still put in work for sure. You definitely don't want to underestimate them completely, and they can have use just like full power Frieza, of course, with the endurance levelation. But outside of that, I don't know. I feel like they definitely are very Zenkai buff dependent at this point, and I'm gonna be honest, they do need a plot equip. I feel like I'm not lying, honestly. I don't know. This is just based off of my use of them lately. You can even watch my recent video with the triple LF tag team. You can kind of tell. So I don't know. That's my thoughts on them. Corrupted Merge Zamazu. Where do I have CMZ? A tier. Yeah, I feel like A tier is a fine spot for him. I think I'll put him like here. I'll put him there. I think that actually that's a fine placement. No, I'll put him there. I think that's fine for CMZ. CMZ with a plot equip would be interesting. The only thing is obviously Beast Gohan exists, so that would definitely be something you do have to keep in mind. But even with Beast Gohan around, I still feel like CMZ with a plot equip could actually be interesting. He definitely wouldn't be in the best spot ever, but he definitely could potentially put in work at that point. It can actually be a decent option in the meta, but I don't know. That's just me though, but CMZ as of right now is just not in the craziest spot. Kaioken Blue. I feel like Bardock is better than Kaioken Blue. Yeah, and pretty much this is where I had him at last time. No. Okay, I saved the tier list. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I think that's a fine spot. Kaioken Blue, I have used him lately. He's okay. You can definitely still put in work and all that stuff use, but he's just not really the craziest ever right now. I don't know, simple as that. So I think that's a fine spot for him. LF Frieza is still quite valuable, but do I think he's S plus tier? I think that's a fine spot for him. I think I will drop him down to S tier this time around. He obviously, his value is crazy for his teams, any team he's on, especially of course LOE, powerful opponent, all those types of teams. He is definitely quite valuable on for sure, but I just because, again, Eloy's not really in as crazy of a spot right now, I do think you do have to keep that in mind, obviously. So yeah, there's the, I don't know, I'll put him there. I do think Vegeta has a little bit more value in this meta just because he can actually be a decent counter versus this guy, and I feel like that does kind of matter right now because he's the best here in the game. So there's that. Trunks. I'll put Trunks here. I don't think he's quite Z tier, but he's like on the cusp. I don't know. You could definitely talk me into putting him Z tier worthy, but I do think Trunks is definitely quite a good unit right now for sure. Obviously, and hybrids, that does give him value. I'll put him on top of S plus tier. I don't think he's like quite like top 10 worthy, but he's like on the cusp. I don't know. I think S plus tier, top of S plus tier, on the verge of Z tier is like, I think is a solid spot for him. Broly. I'm gonna be honest, I've not used Broly lately. I might probably get to use him soon. I don't know. Probably A tier, probably like top of A tier, to be honest. I think like above Gogeta. Yeah, I'll put him above Gogeta only because he has his Platequip, and in the right situation, he can actually, on the right team and in the right situation, he can actually do decent. He can actually do pretty good, but I don't know. I don't know. These two characters are old at this point. I don't know. I'm sure, whatever. It doesn't really matter much. Super Vegito, I did use him lately. Definitely at this point now, he's definitely pretty much fully relegated to just tanking support his damage at this point. It's not really the absolute craziest of all time. I do think here's fine. Yeah, pretty much. I do think there. And then Namek, or to have Namek Goku last time. A tier. Namek Goku, I will say, actually, I did use him lately as well. Because I, you know, again, I've been kind of getting into like revisiting certain characters. By the way, if you've made it to this point in the video yet, just leave in the comment section down below some characters you would want me to revisit that I haven't revisited yet as of late. I know there's a couple of you guys that have requested certain units that I will get to soon. So Don't worry about that, but just request some units that you would potentially want me to revisit. There's that. I don't know. But Namek Goku, he actually did solid. Definitely at this point, he's aged for sure. But he didn't do too bad, actually. So I feel like I might move him up a little bit. I feel like I kind of want to move him up. You know what? I think top of A tier, I think, is a fine spot for him. I actually legitimately do think he's top of A tier. When I used him, granted, I did use him with like Blue Goku Black, who's definitely not a bad unit for sure, but with extra blue cards and all that. And then the third unit I ran was like Kao Ken, but like he put in work. He did put in quite a decent bit of work. Actually, did I even Zenkai buff him any extra? Hold on, let me check real quick. Actually, I didn't even Zenkai buff Namek Goku an extra. So he was just getting one time Zenkai buff. That's it from his own Zenkai ability. So Namek Goku's definitely not too bad. So there's that. So I think this is the final last tier list. I think, let me just double check. I think Beast Gohan is number one. I stand by that. These guys are number two. I do think they're just a tier below Gohan. I think Gohan is the best in everything, better than everything else. Super Saiyan 4 Goku, I do think this is a fine placement. Again, keep in mind, this is an LF Ultra tier list. There's no other units like Pan and all that. So that's why maybe this list might look a little weird. It's missing some units that you would see in a top 10 list, but there's that. Future Gohan, sure. Broly, yeah. Gogeta, Vegito, cooler, Gohan. Yeah, I think that's fine. S plus tier, I think is fine enough. S tier, I think is fine. A tier, I think is fine. And then B tier doesn't really matter, but I think is fine as well. So there's that. I think this is the final last tier list for this month. Again, you don't have to agree with any of my takes. Feel free to discuss down in the comment section down below. Feel free to disagree with my takes. That's completely fine with me. So there's that. Obviously, in terms of last month to this month, different for sure in certain aspects, but definitely I feel like for the most part, with like the bottom end of the tier list, it's changed up a little bit, but it also hasn't changed up as much as I expected it to. So I guess there's that. I was mainly gonna be like the top end of the tier list anyways. I was really gonna change up, so I guess, you know, there's that. But yeah, that being said, definitely let me know what you guys think of the tier list. Leave a like down below in the video if you enjoyed, and also sub the channel. We're going the road to, I guess, 2,000 subs by the end of the year. So yeah, that being said though, hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see y'all in the next one. Peace out. Have a great one, y'all.